Hello, welcome to Insert Techs. Here we'll learn about the transmission element and control system. Today we'll learn about why transmission is required. Transmission system ki requirement kya hai?
Today we will learn what is the requirement of transmission of power. Generally, electricity reaches at our home after going through three general processes, that is power generation, power transmission, and power distribution at the load end. So now the question may arise is, why do not we generate the electricity at the load end itself? What is the requirement of transmission lines? So there are many reasons for that. The first reason is the huge area requirement. That is, a generating station will require huge area, which may not be possible in the city area. Second, the requirement of raw materials such as coal for generating electricity, it will require transportation. Again, that is a difficulty to get in the city area. Third, there are various statutory requirements and government policies that prohibit the generation of electricity in the city area. That also includes various environmental effect that can be caused due to the pollution created. Due to all such reasons, it is very clear that it is not possible to generate electricity at the where the load is situated. Hence, the requirement of transmission lines is always there. Now, as we have understood the requirement of transmitting the power, let us understand how the power is transmitted. Basically, the generating voltages at which the electricity is generated is 11 kV or 6.6 kV. At the load end, the voltage levels are 11 kV, 440 volts or 230 volts for household purposes, and 11 kV are used for the industrial purposes. How do we transmit power from the generating station to the load end? For generating station to load end, can we transmit the power at the generating voltages or load voltages? The answer to this question is no, we cannot transmit the power at the generating voltages. The primary reason for not transmitting the power at generating voltages is that we know that power is equals to voltage into current. In order to transmit the power, either we can increase the voltage levels or we can increase the current. As it can be seen in the diagram, considering the blue circle represents power, the gray circle represents voltage, and the green circle representing current. In order to transmit the same amount of power, either voltage is increased or current is increased. What happens if we increase the current? If the current is increased, the conductor size has to be increased. For small amount of current, the conductor size is small. When the current is high, the conductor size is large. Also, the I square R losses increases by increasing the value of current. Hence, the power is transmitted by increasing the voltage levels. Increasing the voltage, we can transmit the power that is generated at the generating station to the load. There are different voltage levels for the transmission: 33 kV, 66 kV, 132 kV, 220 kilovolts, 400 kV, 765 kV, and 1200 kV. At 1200 kV is the largest voltage at which in India we are transmitting power right now. By changing the voltage levels, the height of the towers will also increase, as it is clearly seen in the picture. So finally, it can be concluded that power transmitted by increasing voltage level is beneficial to the power system. In the upcoming videos, we will understand various elements of the power system. At the generating end, there is a switchyard or a substation. Also, at the load end, there is another substation. There is a transmission line provided between the generating end switchyard and the load end substation. In the next video, we will learn about various elements of the power transmission system.